All right, let's see what goes on this time. I also have a Patreon. Check it out in the description if you want. You get a nice shout out at the end. But either way, let's see. All right, that is better.
Why am I not surprised by this? Oh, and that makes it even worse when she says son of a KU.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Kalo. The little bald crybaby is all grown up. How adorable.
Hello, Martin.
No, that would make sense too. I thought it was Doris.
Hello, Kalo. We meet again at last. I always knew that you'd darken the school again someday.
Oh, please.
I hate her already.
You act like we're some long-lost rivals. We saw each other just last week.
Zip it, Kalo. For once, we're not here to talk about you. We're here to discuss your spawn. Now let's get this over with.
Wow, she's a dick.
Shall we?
Wait. Dora and Bill aren't here yet.
Dora? Late? My, what a shocker.
The sarcasm is off the charts. Hey!
Hey, we're here. Sorry we were late.
I can assure you, Dora, we expected nothing less from you.
Well, I do have my reputation to think about.
All right, enough.
Fashionably late again, Jonas? Fashionably late, huh? Give me a kiss, man. Get out of here. Get out of here!
Chip chat. Take a seat right now.
Take it where, Teach?
Now, this meeting is to discuss the behavior of Alexander Anderson, as well as Amanda and Malcolm Glover. I can't believe I'm saying this. But Kalo, your son could possibly give you a run for your money in terms of your bad behavior. Alexander is quite possibly the single most ill-behaved student that has ever set foot in Auschwitz Elementary School.
Beg to differ.
Huh. Ill-behaved student that has ever stepped foot in Auschwitz Elementary School.
Yeah, of course it had to choose right then to glitch up, just so you had to hear Auschwitz twice. Thrice.
The things that Malcolm has done in my class has likely sunk even lower than the behavior of Dora.
Maybe. But what about all of the horror stories that Mr. Radburn has spun about Alex and Amanda? Don't forget.
I want to see Mr. Ratburn now.
To put up with both of them at the same time.
Ms. Martin, if I may, what has my son been doing?
Oh, Gina. I'm so glad you asked. Let's explore this, shall we? First, there was the time when Alex took my highly expensive car on a joyride.
Ha. This is gonna be all the talk at recess.
I woke up in a new Bugatti.
Nice driving skills there, buddy.
I think you remember the bill I sent you for the damages.
How do I stop this? Crap, 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 crap. I'm in so much trouble.
It's like Ferris Bueller taking the car for a joyride. Say Ferris. Oh, wow. Oh! The only thing that would top it now is if it blows up, and I bet it will immediately. Yep! Also, that looks like Leo's car from the beginning, so I guess... He planted those drugs so Leo got busted. Maybe those are Miss Martin's drugs.
A few weeks ago, he decided it would be amusing to flood the bathroom.
Okay, I used to overflow toilets when I was in school, but it never got that bad. Where did the boat come from? Where did the tree come from?
And of course, he has inherited his father's knack for ditching class. And of course, where else does he go besides?
Dance to the music. Dun, 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 dun. The CH Machine. I remember that. But you can't win the game because by mentioning the game, you automatically lose. So therefore, this creates a paradox and...
What are you doing here?
I'd ask you the same question.
Like father, like son.
Hey, hey, hey. Well, you know us, Kaius. We would move heaven and earth for a trip to Chuck E. Cheese's.
Yeah, I'd have to say that's like the one consistent character trait Kaius has across these videos is that he loves Chuck E. Cheese's.
The only thing that your kid has going for is his ability to maintain decent grades.
Well, my genes have got to be in there somewhere.
Moving on to Malcolm. Hate to say this, Dora, but your son is a right little demon spawn. He has somehow managed to behave even worse than you did.
Wow.
I mean, I'm not saying what he did is right, but like... What, he ditched Claire? Okay, the stealing the car was pretty messed up and fine. Okay, never mind.
It's nice to know that I've got someone looking up to me and following in my footsteps.
This isn't a joke, Dora. Malcolm has been crossing the line ever since he stepped foot in the school. Last month, he snuck into the school at night and greased up all of the floors, causing people to slip and bust their asses.
Is this... Why does the elementary kid have a full beard? Nice. Also, that remind his hairstyle. Tell me more, tell me more. I mean, I guess that's what you were going for with them slipping on grease, and it's a reference to grease, so is that a meta joke?
Come here, I'm gonna kick your ass.
He somehow hacked into the school's network and program.
I love that video.
The projectors to display porno.
Of course, seeing Barney Bunch videos. That probably has more connotations. Hemaha bag, that was swell.
Yesterday, I caught him peeing in my coffee. Not to mention the time where he parked my car on the school's rooftop.
And then you said, dude, where's my car? And then you tell me where my car is, and then I find my car, and then if you're gonna, I'm gonna kick your ass if you say and then one more time. And then! How do you even get it up there?
I still can't figure out how he managed to do that.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Wow.
Actually, I did say.
Baby, we raised an artist.
Though this is in no way a laughing matter. I haven't even gotten started on all the crap Amanda has pulled.
Oh? Let's hear.
Last Wednesday, Mr. Redburn sent her to my office because he caught her cheating on a test. She failed, by the way.
She's not the you are not the father of that test.
Has a tendency to sneak into the front office and blast SpongeBob music on the intercom. While the...
That's random because I'm about to go see SpongeBob the Musical with someone offline.
Music plays. She likes to ride a bicycle down the school halls.
I've got a bike. You can ride it if you like.
Oh. And I'm not even going to bring up the time that she put Gorilla Glue in my chair.
And I have had enough. I'm getting sick.
But you did just bring it up.
Sick of Toilet Man asking me for raises because your kids make his job 10 times harder.
Even she calls him the Toilet Man!
I'm tired of filling out paperwork because of the destruction that
Mr. Morris, the Toilet Man,
have caused. And I look around this room. And I can clearly see the cause for all of this behavior. Little Pill. Dora the motherfucking Explorer. And of course...
Ronald McGoddamn Donald!
Kalo.
Also, I didn't even realize that she married Little Bill, though that makes sense.
The worst kid to ever step foot in this godforsaken school. The kid who...
Well, with a name like Auschwitz, what do you expect about... You expect it to be godforsaken, right?
Single-handedly made my job as a teacher one great big Viking f***ing nightmare.
Well, you clearly still have that same set of lungs on you.
F***ing nightmare.
What did she say?
Made my job as a teacher one great big wanking f***ing nightmare.
I thought she said wanking for a second.
You clearly still have that same set of lungs on you.
Learn how to be a parent, you dumbass. Then I wouldn't have to yell.
Uh-oh. Oh, yeah.
You want to know why you get so much disrespect? It's because of this. You are completely crazy. We will deal with our kids' behavior. But you have no place to be telling us how to deal with our kids.
Well, clearly you don't know how to. Someone has to act.
Martin, if I ever hear of you verbally abusing my kids again, I'm gonna break my foot off in your ass.
Oh, shit!
The challenge?
Oh,
come
no.
Have a go if you're feeling strong enough.
Round one.
All right, let's stop right here. What's gonna happen? I have no idea, but where did the announcer come from? I also have no idea. Where are my pants? I have no freaking idea.